Yep, we go. Door.
Okay, Hotshot, what's next?
Now we rescue Citizen Brown, get the hell out of here, and get things back to the way they're supposed to be.
Whatever, just as long as I get to break some stuff. I've got a lot of pent-up hostility right now, you know?
Miss Parker.
What the?
Yeah!
I'm here to escort you to the lobby. Your father's waiting for you.
Can he wait? I was hoping that this attractive young man could take me on a tour of the facilities.
I'm afraid I really must insist, miss.
Relax, Jennifer. I've got everything under control.
Really?
Really.
Okay, then. But first...
What was that for?
For saving me, dummy. Let's go, officer.
You know, I'm probably gonna have to write you up for a PDA violation.
Bite me.
What?
Rock and roll.
Okay.
I used to think she was a little annoying, but now she's just plain evil.
Yeah, so rescue Doc.
Looks like a giant air freshener. Weird. I don't know what kind of movies they're showing Doc, but I don't think he's enjoying them.
Oh!
Jeez. He looks miserable.
Can I have some of that? Feels like I haven't eaten in years.
No, that's tannins. He's not allowed to eat it until he's taken his pacification pill. We tried to give it to him an hour ago, but he still hasn't swallowed it.
Let me try. I could be pretty persuasive.
No.
No.
Occipital
overrides. Maybe I could talk to Doc from there. That speaker looks really familiar.
Yeah, that's a clue, I'd say. Oh.
Wow, they've really got this door locked up tight. I wonder what sick freak they've got in here. I should have known.
Yeah, I think we need to get him over the intercom.
Oh!
Hi, Biff. Looks like your intercom's busted. Just as well. It'd probably be just a bunch of swearing and mixed metaphors anyway. Want out of here, big guy? Guess they don't work. Hey, Biff. Guess who your guard is? Peekaboo! The guard says I'm not supposed to give you any food until you swallow your pill.
I have some of that? Feels like I haven't eaten in years.
No, that's tannins. He's not allowed to eat it until he's taken his pacification pill. We tried to give it to him an hour ago, but he still hasn't swallowed it.
Let me try.
I could be pretty persuasive.
No. Don't touch that! I need the caffeine. Do you mind? I'm trying to run a complete personality rebuild on the big man himself here.
And?
And the last thing I need is your stubby little fingers turning Hill Valley's savior into a drooling rutabaga.
Is there a problem over there, citizen?
No problem, ma'am.
Good. Let's get back to it.
No improvement, citizen.
Hi, Biff. on, Biff. Just swallow your pill. I almost feel sorry for the poor guy. Almost. Hi, Biff.
How do I get him to eat the pill?
Bye, Biff.
Alright. Maybe you won't do it now.
What are you doing in here?
Looking for the bathroom?
The next scheduled bathroom break isn't for another 158 minutes.
Right.
Don't worry, Emmett. It'll all be over soon.
It looks like she's got a direct line into that speaker.
Yeah, I get it. It's just the Biff thing. I need his help.
Hey! Get me out of here!
Sorry, can't hear you in this thing, but thanks for the duds, though. It's broken. I guess Jen did that so the guard won't be able to call for help. There's no one in my cell to talk to. There's nothing I need in there.
Okay.
Stop fighting it, darling. You're only hurting yourself.
Jesus, this is hard already. Biff won't eat the pill.
Jeez, everyone's a critic. Hi, Biff. Want out of here, big guy? Guess they don't work.
Okay, I need more.
Bye, Biff.
No.
Alright, so I need to get rid of him, is it?
No!
I'd never get my hand under there.
The newspaper, maybe? I get it. Okay.
Hi, Biff. Come on, Biff, just swallow your pill.
Thank you.
Oh, Biff spit. Biff's sedative is kind of on the large side. I don't think he'll intentionally take a knockout pill.
No, he needs to slip it into his drink or something. Though.
Hey, is that a public display of affection over there?
What? Sorry, it was just a shadow. Stop goofing around and get back to work!
Yes, sir.
Jeez, what have they been feeding Biff? Horse tranquilizers?
Okay, that's...
Yo, God!
Who, me? I mean...
Me?
Yes, you! As you can see, that slacker of a technician is sleeping on the job again. Please be a dear and tend to the Citizen Plus control panel, will you?
Sure.
Okay, Doc, I'm in. Now, how do I get you out of here without turning you into a vegetable? He'll be out for a while. Jeez, where's the off button on this thing? Hey, an equalizer. At least, I think it's an equalizer. Tactile.
Oh!
Sorry. Optics. Factory. I think I know what that means.
What the?
Looks like the aroma tanks have clogged themselves again.
Oh, thank you. I hadn't noticed that. Come on, make yourself useful.
Mingo.
I'm sorry about the delay, dear. This'd go a lot easier if you just gave up this madness about time machines and altering the past. You should concentrate on the future.
There is no future for us.
You won't think that in a few more hours.
And, please... Think about the consequences of your actions.
Me? You're the one threatening the social order of Hill Valley with your crazy time machine talk.
Okay, we've gotten that sorted. We need to...
Hear something?
No, ma'am.
I could have sworn I heard some of that rock and or roll music.
It needs more volume.
Where's Martin?
Don't worry, dear. After we're done repairing your damaged mind, we'll fix young Mr. McFly, too.
Volume. Finally, a word I can understand. Okay, that moved him a few inches. Maybe I can blast him right out the door.
Yeah.
When did I lose control?
Oh, dearest. You never had control. That's why you needed me in the first place. What was that? You! What are you doing?
Get my friend out of here, you nutcase! Okay, that was a little less dramatic than I had expected.
Whoa!
Go, Your Honor.
Hot! I can't hear you!
You're welcome!
Damn you, Blackhead! What the heck was Edna doing to you back there?
She was trying to rebuild my personality from the ground up, erasing the parts she didn't like.
Very much the Nurse Ratched kind of personality.
Hey, it's my mom! Hey!
Don't talk to her. She could give us away.
What do we do now?
Now we wait for the guards to clear out so we can make a break for your time machine.
Shouldn't we go help?
Once we go back and change history, none of this will ever happen.
I guess. No offense, Your Honor, but why'd you marry Edna anyway? She's kind of crazy.
Yes, now. But back when we were first dating, her manners was tempered by an ironclad sense of right and wrong. At least, that's how it seemed to me at the time.
Shot.
All right, Dad. Where is the DeLorean anyway?
I had the wreck towed to my secret lab near Clayton Ravine.
Nice.
Clayton Ravine, as in Clara Clayton?
Why is that significant?
Yes.
Well, Clara's kind of supposed to be your wife, so yeah.
Fascinating.
Mom, Dad, no!
They'll be fine. Once we repair the time stream, none of this will ever have happened.
I guess you're right.
Looks like the coast is clear.
Great! Let's go fix the DeLorean.
I'm afraid I'll have to do that without you, Martin.
What? Why?
Well, from what little I understand of time travel, if you help me rebuild the time machine, your presence in the repair efforts could cause some sort of temporal paradox after we return to 1931.
So what am I supposed to do? Just hang out here in Bizarro Hill Valley until you fix the time machine?
Exactly. But don't worry, if things work out according to plan, you won't even notice I'm gone.
You know, for a second there, you sounded almost as confusing as the real Doc.
See? We're making progress already. See you soon, Martin.
Good luck, Your Honor.
Oh, and you might want to stay off the streets for a few seconds.
Stay off the street? Citizen Brown? Emmett?
Nourish. I think now is a good time to stop. I've gone quite far again. I cannot help myself. It's just gotten too important in the story to keep pausing and, you know, waiting to play again. So, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.